हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। बस
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग सर, वेलकम।
थैंक यू। होप एवरीवन इज इन गुड हेल्थ।
पार्डन सर,
मैं कहा होप एवरीवन इज इन गुड हेल्थ।
यस सर, यस सर, यस सर, डेफिनेटली। एंड हाउ आर यू?
I am fine. How is the corona situation there in Nagpur?
It is stable, but not good.
Good. Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes, sir, we can.
Thank you. Thank you.
Madam, shall we start?
Namaskar. Welcome to one and all. My humble homage to Dr. Bhausaheb Panjabrao Deshmukh, founder president of Sri Shivaji Education Society, honorable chief guest Dr. Mohan Kherde sir, director Knowledge Resource Center Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University Amravati, respected resource person Dr. Rakesh Mohindra sir, University Business School, Punjab University, Chandigarh, from our principal, Dhanwate National College, Dr. Surendra Jiskar, sir, IQAC coordinator, Dr. Ratnakar Bhilkar, sir, IQAC co-coordinator, Dr. Kulbhushan Meghe, sir, co-convener of this webinar, Dr. Pavin Ghosekar, sir, and all the participants and my dear students, welcome to one and all. For the national webinar series of last day, and the today's topic is open educational resources is the need of hour. The resource person is Dr. Rakesh Mohindra, University Business School, Punjab University, Chandigarh. Before starting today's session, let's have a small concluding session. It's our privilege that we have such a eminent people among us. Our honorable chief guest, Dr. Mohan Kherde sir, director, Knowledge Resource Center, Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University, Amravati, and he is my guru. Program president. Now I request Dr. Kulbhushan Meghe sir to give an overview for our 7 days national webinar series. Over to Meghe sir.
Thank you, madam. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. First, I pay my homage to Dr. Bhausaheb Deshmukh, founder of Sri Shivaji Education Society, respected principal Dr. Jiskar sir, speaker of today's session, Dr. Rakesh Mohindra sir, chief guest Dr. Mohan Kherde sir, convener of the webinar Dr. Vaishali Marode madam, co-convener Dr. Pravin Ghosekar sir. Welcome to last session of the webinar. In the 7 days webinar on access to open educational resources, 7 sessions were addressed by 7 eminent speakers from Bangalore, Chandigarh, Wardha, and Nagpur. The plan of various sessions in this webinar is meticulously worked, which give justice to different dimensions of open educational resources. This webinar offers unique opportunity to students to exchange information, ideas, facts on open educational resources first time in such pandemic situation. The entire sessions were interactive and practical based. In today's session, resource person Dr. Rakesh Mohindra sir, Punjab University Chandigarh, and the chief guest of the valedictory session is Mohan Kherde, Director, Knowledge Resource Center, Sant Gadge Baba, Amravati University. We have received overwhelming response to this webinar. More than 350 delegates, including students, participants from West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, and South India. Hope this webinar will be practical use to explore open educational resources to all stakeholders. With thanks, I conclude my overview of this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Then I request Dr. Muktai madam to introduce today's chief guest, Dr. Mohan Kherde, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. A very warm welcome to one and all. I, Dr. Muktai Chavan Dev, feel honored to introduce today's chief guest, Dr. Mohan Kherde, Director, Knowledge Resource Center, Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University. Dr. Kherge has a vast experience, 19 years as a college librarian, 11 years as a director, and 14 years of teaching experience too. Sir has to his credit a portal which provides access to e-resources which has users from more than 50 countries. Leave no one behind. A sustainable development goal has also been taken ahead by Sir by developing an enabling unit for differently abled persons. He has also developed open consortia for colleges titled Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University Library Consortia for UG and PG students. No thief, however skillful, can rob one of knowledge. And that is why knowledge is best and safest treasure to acquire, says L. Frank Baum. Knowing this, Sir has constantly been organizing short-term courses for librarians as well as staff members along with students. Sir has extensive research background, 2 books as an author, 19 journal articles, 22 papers of national, international and state level, 50 plus invitations as a resource person and a speaker in various workshops and seminars. 6 PhD students have been awarded PhD under his able guidance, and 8 are still in the process. 15 plus speeches in various webinars. He is a member in many university committees of Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University, as well as YCMOU, Nagpur University, SNDT, and SRTM. Sir has also been awarded as the best academic librarian by ILA along with ILA Promoter Award in 1995 and 96. He holds many prominent positions such as President Maharashtra University and College Librarians Association, President of Library and Imprisoned Science Study Center, Amravati. Friends, we are really having to see a different aspect of his personality, that he is also a professional artist as well as a singer. Friends, it is indeed our pleasure to have amongst us a multifaceted personality. We welcome you, sir, to this valedictory function of 7-day national webinar on access to open educational resources. Welcome, sir, to this valedictory function. I hand over the fora to you.
Good morning, all of you.
Good morning.
Thank you, madam, for my nice introduction. At the outset, I pay my homage to Dr. Bhausaheb Deshmukh, the first Agriculture Minister of India. This 7-day webinar organized by Sri Shivaji Education Societies, Dharwad National College, Nagpur. The principal of this college, Dr. Surendra Jiskar, sir, resource person of today's webinar, Dr. Rakesh Mohinder from Chandigarh, Dr. Kulbushan Meghe, IQC coordinator, Dr. Vaishali Marode Vadnerkar, convener of this webinar, Dr. Praveen Ghosekar, co-convener of this webinar. First of all, I must extend my sincere thanks to the organizer for giving me opportunity to put my views before you as a chief guest of today's event. Moreover, I must congratulate organizer for being organized this 7-day webinar on access to open educational resources, and especially today's subject topic is on OER, that is open educational resources, need of the hours. Friends, the concept of OER is just latest, it is a latest concept. The government of India, in collaboration with NCERT and MHRD, take an initiative to develop a project that is NROER, that is National Repository of Open Educational Resources, which is launched on 13th August 2013. It means this concept is new. It is to be grown out. But because of this lockdown period, the importance of such a initiatives now come forward. So far as education, open educational resources are concerned, it is nothing but it is freely accessible, open license documents and media that are useful for teaching, learning, research, and assessing also. If you just see the characteristic of OER, I know Dr. Mohinder will focus on this particular part, but I would like to put some points before you regarding OER, basic points. I'm not going detail. If you see the characteristic of OER, you must see 5 R's. That is very much important, 5 R's. That is retain, reuse, revise, remix, and redistribute. In this 5 R, all the characteristics of OER will come. Retain means you can freely download any kind of document available in this repository. You can storage it, you can manage it. That is the first characteristic of OER. Reuse means it is right to use the content in a wide range of users. Many users can, at a time, can use this particular repository 24/7. Then revise. Revise means you can translate these documents in your own language because it openly licensed. That's why you can translate it. You can remix it with the help of original content given in that particular repository. You can develop new one. Means you can remix it and you can transmit it to others. That is redistribution. I mean, these are the characteristics of all these open educational research. Now, so far as so many different types of OER are there, that is open courseware, the subject specific open courseware, open schooling initiatives, so many are there. Actually, it is nothing but a new dimension for the traditional teaching learning process. Now, online or e-learning concept is coming because of this lockdown. Now it is need of the day. So open educational resource is also very much important considering the present situation of the world. That's why I'm saying that I can say congratulations to particular organizer because they are choosing such kind of subject topic for this webinar. Now, so many benefits are there for open digital resources. Or you can say, first of all, it's freely available. You need not to pay for that. It is open for all. Anybody can take advantage of this open educational resources. It is open. You can use at any place at any time. Means 24/7 it is open. Then another thing is that it is easy to use because it is very much useful. It is user friendly. These are the benefits. Apart from that, so many benefits are there. I will not focus each and every benefits of this particular things because I know this person is Dr. Mahendra. He can very well focus all these points. But friends, some challenges are also there. That means some system is there. When system come in focus, no system in the world is 100% perfect. In physics, we can say that there is no efficiency of any machine that is 100% or one. Or another way, there is no any body which is perfectly black. It means that whenever any system comes in existence, nothing is perfect. All is perfect. That's why research is going on. Yes, I mean, research is important because of that. No system is perfect. In the same way, this open educational resources, this concept is also not perfect. This system is also not perfect. Many benefits are there. It is very much useful. It is very useful for in teaching learning process. No doubt, but some parts are there. When it's openly available, it is freely available. Some challenges are there. Because when we are talking about open educational resources, that means these are in digital form. It is available through network. So that's why our network facility should be strong. If you have to take advantage of these open educational resources, then your network facility must be strong. Unfortunately, we are talking about e-learning. We are talking about online courses. We are talking about online teaching learning process. Yes, we are doing in all this in this lockdown period. But so many disadvantages are also there. So many challenges are also there. People, those are living in remote places. They are facing this problem. They could not connect to these classes. So these problems are there. So same problem you should have to face in open educational resources, that is strong network facility. That is challenge, big challenge, that we have to overcome it. Definitely in near future, we will be strong in this particular part. But at present, it is a challenge for us. Now, second thing is that when all is open, everything is available. In open digital resources, everything is available for anybody. Anybody can use it. Anybody can access it. Anybody can store it. Anybody can manage it. In that case, student has to take care because students are nothing but end users of this system. Or you can say student is a base of that, is a center point. Students are the center points of such kind of systems. So student must take care, not only student, but faculty also, teachers also, that whatever be available on open educational resources, you have to check its quality. Because in every case, because so many open educational resources are there, repositories are there, all repositories are not up to the mark. Standard repositories, when the content come in that particular repository, before managing content in that repository, first of all, these repository are to be checked by the experts. They check that content, and after checking that particular content, then standard repositories manage it on the for the public. So while doing all these things, while taking advantage of open educational resources, we must take care that the quality must be up to the mark. It should be checked first, because that assurance should be there. Otherwise, wrong information may transmit to the end users, that is to the students. So in that case, we must take care that we must use standard open educational resources repositories. Then another thing is that we must check what is the amendment in that content. Many times what happened, contents are there in that repository, but they are not being upgraded. They are not being amended. They are not being changed according to the time. They are not developed according to time. Once it is developed, once the repository developed, because many repositories are depends on the financial resources. Government or any financial agencies provide funds to develop such kind of repositories, open educational resource repositories. Because that, but that funds are one-time fund, financial reports are there. It is not, they are not receiving these funds periodically. One-time funds are there. That's why once these repositories are being developed, it is to be maintained by developing the content, changing the content, amend the content. That part is not seen in many repositories. The challenges are there. The challenges we are facing. That's why when faculty members, teachers, students using this open educational resources, or when in higher education, stakeholders are using open educational resources, in that case, they must take care about this amendment, quality, all these things. So these are the challenges, but though these are challenges, all these challenges we will overcome, because now education system is going to be changed. Now it is a requirement, because of such kind of situations, we have to turn towards another kind of teaching learning process. We have to just check what is the benefits of traditional teaching process, and we have to turn towards the another way. Yes, because now our classroom teaching should be go beyond the classroom. It should not be restricted up to class. And that's why such kind of open educational resources are needed. And that's why I'm saying that what topic chosen by the organizer, really it is good one. Really it is beneficial for the audience, because I just gone through the brochure of this webinar. Your students are also participating in this particular part, particular events. For them also, such kind of webinar will be beneficial. So I just say thanks to organizer for giving me opportunity to put my views before you as a chief guest, and give me opportunity to being a chief guest of this webinar. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your valuable guidance for us. Very few time from institutional repository to open educational resources. Now I request Dr. Surendra Jitkar, sir, for his presidential address. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. My salutations to Rashtra Sangat Tukaroji Maharaj and our founder president, Dr. Bhausaheb Panjabrao Deshmukh, respected Dr. Mohanji Khede sir, Director, Knowledge Resource Center, SVG Amravati University, today's speaker, Dr. Rakesh G. Mohindra, University Business School of Punjab University. Our IQSC coordinator, Dr. Bhilkar sir, Dr. Vaishali Malode, madam, convener of this event, Dr. Kulbhushan Meghe, co-coordinator of IQSC, Dr. Praveen Gosekar, sir, co-coordinator of this event, and all the participants. As all of you know, that we are in a very peculiar situation. And this situation, as far as education institutes are concerned, we are, as far as teaching is concerned and our education system is concerned, we have moved from F2F to ERT, that is face-to-face teaching, what we were following till now, to emergency remote teaching. Now, emergency remote teaching is that teaching that changes the mode of teaching in any emergency crisis. When the crisis comes, we move from F2F to any emergency. And what we have adopted now is teaching through internet. There is a vast difference on online teaching and ERT. Online teaching, the curriculum is entirely different. And the curriculum has to be designed for online teaching by the university or any competent authority. Now, what we are doing, we are using the F2F curriculum and converting into an online mode. Now, this open education resource, there should be, why it is important, because it gives variety of material from which a class without, class can be developed from the scratch. And there should be an integration of OER into your emergency remote teaching. Now, it is the society which gives you information, where the society is the environment, your parents, school, colleges, teachers, everyone. When you perceive that information, it is knowledge. And when you practice knowledge, it is wisdom. So as far as information is concerned, it's like an ocean. It's a huge ocean of information. Now, what is required at this moment is management of that information for a smooth, free flowing. And because of that, OER plays a very important role. As rightly said by Mohanji, the authenticity of OER plays an important role. There are ample information available on the net. It's open.
नाही कॉलेज लाच आहे ना ते हे चालू आहे ना कॉन्फरन्स व्हॅलिडिक्टरी
पराग प्लीज म्यूट युअर माइक पराग प्लीज म्यूट युअर माइक थँक्यू द ऑथेंटिसिटी ऑफ ओईआर इज इम्पॉर्टंट सो गव्हर्नमेंट इज प्लेइंग एन इम्पॉर्टंट रोल देर आर एनजीओज देर आर इन्स्टिट्यूशन देर आर other platforms which are playing an important role for the authenticity of this OER. I won't take much time because we want to listen to our experts over here. But then OER, it's an affordable material to students as well as faculty. And what my perception of OER is, as far as faculty is concerned or anyone who doesn't get a platform, it provides a platform for performance to enhance or modify their own work. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity. And thank you, sir, for coming to this event. And I will hand over this because we want to listen to the experts over here. Thank you and namaskar to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for your valuable thoughts and giving such an opportunity to me for conducting this webinar. Thank you. Now I request Dr. Praveen Ghosekar sir to introduce Rakesh Mohindra sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Today we are having
Dr. Praveen Ghosekar sir.
Am I audible, ma'am? Am I audible?
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Today we are having eminent resource person Dr. Rakesh Mohindra sir. Dr. Rakesh Mohindra is postgraduate in geography, public administration and library and information science from Punjab University Chandigarh. He did his doctorate on library service quality of Indian law university from Kurukshetra University Kurukshetra. He had edited 4 books and published more than 10 papers in research journals. He has also presented papers in national and international conferences and visited more than 15 countries and also chaired the session. Dr. Mohindra is a very active member of Chandigarh Library Association and a council member of Indian Library Association. Over the years, he has mastered in quantitative data analysis and have good experience of statistical analysis in SPSS. He has processed more than 1500 PhD studies submitted in various universities and PGIMER Chandigarh. He has expertise in empirical research method. Dr. Rakesh is presently working in Punjab University, heading the law faculty library. He provides assistance in plagiarism checking to Turnitin and Urkund software and peer knowledge to guide research scholars in applying citation while writing research reports. I request Dr. Mohindra sir to start his session. Over to Mohindra sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ravi. Thank you very much. First of all, I am very thankful for inviting me for today's webinar. Dr. Deshmukh, the president of Shivaji Education Society, under whose able guidance the Dhanvanti National College is running, and Professor Surinder Jacob, principal Dhanvanti National College, Nagpur, Dr. Mohan R. Karde, the chief guest for today's webinar, who is heading a Knowledge Resource Center, SGB University, Amravati, Dr. Kulbhushan, coordinator of this webinar, Dr. Vishali Banade, librarian, National Dhanvanti National College, Nagpur, and Dr. Praveen, convener of this week-long webinar. I'm very thankful for inviting me today's webinar. As I am a, you can say, non-digital native, I studied for my graduation, post-graduation, the computer was nowhere. So we started, when I joined the job also in Punjab University, there was no computer at all. So the whole thing started, the whole IT, information technology, information communication technology, these are all started later on. So while doing our job, while pursuing our career, we learned everything. So these were possible only due to open education resources and in-service trainings and with from colleagues. So today I am speaking on open education resources, need of the hour. As you know, we have facing a very difficult situation due to pandemic, and we have to emerge with the new systems, new services, and new technologies to impart knowledge, to share information for getting solution as well as pursuing any education courses during this time. So as you know, with the advent of internet technologies, the information technologies has totally changed our life. We are doing every activity of human, you can say, movement with some type of internet technologies or through various ICT technologies. So the education technologies has impacted the education and learning the most, because through education we can learn life skills and we can pursue for careers. And if we have some basic knowledge of ICT, it is very important to learn and get educated. So I'm just opening my PPT. So today I am speaking basically on open education resources need of the hour. As Dr. Karde told you about open education resources, and you must have heard a lot of things about open education resources for the last webinars, where experts have given you how to search the search engines, how to deal with the information technology challenges, and on many other important topics. So today I am basically dealing with the open education resources, and I think I have now 25 or 30 minutes to complete my presentation and give you an overview of what are the open education resources, how we can best make use of open education resources. Basically, when we speak of open education resources, it has two contexts. It has different context for the teachers, and it has different context for the students. Because when we talk about open education resources for teachers, it is basically how teachers should design and develop education resources for the students. And when we talk of open education resources, it is for the students how the things are presented, how informative is the open education resources, how reliable is the information, and how beautifully it has been designed to learn things through open education resources, where intervention of the instructor is minimal. The student is learning in his own way, and it is entirely on the quality of open education resources through which student learn the best. So when he is looking for open education resources, it is very important for the teachers to develop education resources according to the student level, student education level, the best contents and the methodology. So it is a very vast context in respect of teachers as well as students. So as I told you, we are now living in a digital environment. We are performing all our activities through digitally. If we want to get a job, we are now applying digitally. We are communicating our biodata, our CV, we are applying through digital mode. We are learning in a digital mode. We are doing shopping. We are doing online digitally. If we are having any illness, we are now going through some digital, you can say, treatment, like we are getting diagnostic test and we are getting the report digitally. We are engaging in all activities through digital, even if we are getting entertained through digital mode. So when we are talking about a digital environment, we need a digital literacies. So when I speak of digital literacy, it is basically what basic skills we have in a digital context through which we can interact and we can serve through digital platforms. So basically, digital literacy requires basically four skills: communication skills, information skills, information management skills, problem solving skills. So in digital platform, these basic four skills are very much required to work in a very optimal manner. So when we say that the digital literacies, it requires to acquire certain competencies. If we see the digital competencies, we can divide them into five major competencies which are required to work on any digital platform. These five digital competencies are digital content creation, on digital problem solving, information and data literacy, communication and collaboration. These are basic five digital competencies which we require to interact on digital platforms. So when we deal with digital competency, it basically requires digital literacy on many aspects, like we need to know about computer hardware, how the computer functions, what are the basic component of computers, how the softwares are handled by the computer, how we can run audiovisual material on digital on computers, how we can interact with the help of internet and get our work through our desktop computer, which is connected with the internet, and so on. So now today, the teaching learning environment has totally changed. Now we are moving towards more online learning platforms where we are imparting and getting education through different platforms in an online learning environment. Distance learning, it is very fastly transforming into online learning mode. Blending learning, when we speak of learning in a distance learning or in a direct to face-to-face, again, there are blending methods where we are integrating online resources in teaching and learning. There are virtual learning platforms where we can learn at our own pace, at our own, you can say, places, and e-learning mode, where a lot of e-learning resources are there. You can enroll yourself for the e-learning courses, and you can learn on different subject matter. So a virtual education landscape have certain components. Basically, these are like academic institutions which are working in a virtual environment, and they are imparting academic literacies through online mode. New literacies are also there, where the one can learn lifelong learning skills through virtual educational mode. Then we require a media literacy also, where we can handle different type of material which are useful to getting educated or to getting learned some subject matter. Like we need a text, we need a audiovisual material, and so on. And digital literacy, as I have already told you in my previous slide. So when we see the virtual learning environment, it has face-to-face on-site interaction mode. It has professional learning teams who have in the background developed the online resources. We have study groups where we interact online with the people who are studying same subject matter or same course. We have online textbooks, reading material. We have a platform where we can go for different webinars. Like today we are interacting on a webinar. We have university courses which are imparted through distance learning in an online environment. So when we speak of open education resources, it basically have certain medium also, and as well as we can classify into different types. Open education resources have certain open courseware, like we can do graduation, post-graduation or diploma courses through open education platform. We can learn different objects. We can learn at our own pace different software, or we can get some skills learned through open education resources. These are all available in an open platform, means you can use them freely and at your own convenience. We have digital tutorials. Many educational institutions, many experts, now they are providing digital tutorials like Khan Academy and many other similar platforms are there, where digital tutorials are also available, which you can go through and learn different subjects. Open journals, where we can publish and we can get scholarly information with the help of article published. Streaming videos like YouTube, which is a very excellent open education resource. So all these open resources are available on different platforms in some particular type. Some platforms have a lot of more than two or three types integrated into a single platform. So demystifying the online learning, basically when earlier we were talking of online learning, we have certain myths. It's like it is very difficult to learn in an online environment, but these were all myths, different myths. Now learning how to learn is very, very easy. Like now lot of people are spending lot of time in a internet digital environment. So they are performing all their activities in a network environment, which is where their devices or they are working in a network environment, which is connected and all the information is communicated through internet. So there was other myth like online learning is a very fixed pattern. No, online learning has a very flexible delivery of interaction, and where the students can interact with the online learning platform at his own time, at his own place without any geographical barrier and so on. Online learning platforms are very high tech, but nowadays they are very simple to use and very simple to interact with. And online learning environment, they impart very up-to-date information technologies to make the platform very simple and very fast interaction is there. So this I am not going into detail because I have very less time. The design of OER, as Dr. Karde spoke in his president, means chief guest address, that nowadays it is very important that open education resources should be very relevant and very reliable while imparting education in education institutions. Because nowadays we are now taking a lot of help of open education resources by teachers who are teaching in different education institutions to cover their course content for any degree or for any diploma courses. So when we design open education resources, we need to have proper assessment tools. We need to integrate a social platform. We need to have a web conference facilities. We need to have a learning management system where we can, you can say, monitor the progress of learning. And we need to have a content management system where we can manage the content of open education resources. So I'm just leaving this slide with you. You can just see the topic, the different things which are needed to design for a open education resources. So again, I am skipping all of the open education resources. The center point is learner. So everything is learner is designed keeping in view the learner in mind. So all the skills which are being imparted through open education resources, how the learner can skill, it is going through outer, like how the open education resources is designed. Basically, learner is in the center place. Then we need key skills. We need what subject content is to be covered, what advanced information handling is to be done, how the learning is taken place, whether it is going the in a audio-visual mode, or whether there is a presentation by an expert, or there is an assignment, or there is a quiz like that. So open as Dr. Cardet or the other resource person who have given you the presentation in last 6 days, they might have told you about open education resources. Basically, it is these are free of cost. We can adapt them, we can redistribute them, and it has open license for any intellectual property. So I'm not going into detail. The features of open education resources, basically the open education resources are available in a textbook form, e-books form, journal, magazine, reports, newspaper articles, audiovisual material, databases, open access resources like databases, journals, and so on, and open education courses. So like I told you, the open education resources are available through open lessons, which has the peculiar lessons format to get it under open education lessons. So benefit, already you have, Dr. Karde gave you a brief overview of benefit of open education resources. I'm not going into detail. The challenges of open education resources, as you know, the open education resources have a lot of challenges because everyone is using open education resources at his own place, at his own time, and he has a specific level of education and knowledge where he has to understand the open education resources covering a different subject matter. So we need to have open education resources for graduation level, school level, or a post-graduation level. So it is a challenge for designing open education resources for students of different level. We need to have a specific skills to design the open education resources. We need to have see what are the platforms where the education resources being run, how the education resources interact with the learner, and so on. We need to design open education resources where minimal internet connectivity is required. People can download the open education resources and they can use the open education resources in an offline mode also. So these are the challenges which are very much faced by open education resources designers and teachers. So open education resources landscape has a very peculiar, you can say, format where we have open education resources. It has different academic, socio-cultural sphere. We have a business where the universities who are now designing and developing open education resources in a very economical way, so they can teach and get the learning through different open education, development of open education resources in a very economical way. There are legal aspects also, which has to be dealt with the open education resources, as we have to design everything in a open lessons. We need to have a policy also, how to put open education resources for graduation, post-graduation level, and what subject matter they will cover, and how much content we have to cover through open education resources. Like nowadays, in the very difficult situation, most of the teaching institutions or academic institutions, they are now putting lot of education resources in on their website. They are putting very less you can say consideration, but coverage is being done by open education resources. So it is very important to have a proper policy to start with open education resources. So we need a technology platform also. These are the basic components to have open education, proper open education landscape of any education institution. So now I basically give you just a brief overview. What are the open education resources which are available on NLIST? I think your librarian, Dr. Vishali, might have given a proper presentation, orientation, presentation, how to make use of NLIST program, which is available through National Library Information Services Infrastructure by InfibroNet to the college students. It has a lot of journals, ebooks, and so on. I'm not going into detail. You can explore the NLIST resources by getting enrollment and getting your password. Nowadays, we have a lot of new resources under this platform. We have an advanced facility in this platform. So one thing which I want to share with you is, whenever you are getting any information for learning anything, it is very important to work in a very systematic on internet. As we, most of us are doing searching on the various search engines like Google, Yahoo, and so on, it is very important to basically get ourselves trained in a searching technique. So which I will just tell you, whenever you are working for any academic information, or you want to learn any on any subject matter at your own, it is very important you start your searching in a very typical manner, in a Google search engine or any other search engine. So SHOKSIDHU is another Government of India initiative to provide online information resources to the students in colleges and as well as in the universities. So EG Pathshala, the earlier presenter have already gave you presentation about what are information education resources available under EG Pathshala program of Government of India. We have EADM, ebooks, UG MOOCs, online courses are also available under UGC MOOC platform. We have ePathya. We have different educational resources on, we have different textbooks under ePathya program. These are the subject where different resources are there under ePathshala program. eAcharya program is another Government of India initiative under MHRD project, where lot of educational resources are now being hosted for getting yourself education at any level. There is a virtual lab by Government of Human Resource Development Ministry, where now lot of colleges can perform the lab experiment through virtual lab program of Government of India. There are another very important platform at the international level, Spoken Tutorial. This platform has many open source software where you can learn the software at your own level, and there are courses that are also available where you can get yourself registered to learn software at your place. There are audiovisual tutorials also where you can learn different part of your course through audiovisual resources. So spoken tutorials have almost all the softwares which you can learn. I have learned the SPSS by using many spoken tutorial audiovisual tutorial. So there are many resources available in the NILET platform where you can learn different. So you can get through A-level courses, O-level courses, and advanced computer courses by getting yourself registered under NILET program, where you have different bachelor level and master level courses there. So if you get registered under Khan Academy, is another international platform where you can get yourself for different courses and get many subject content learned by registering yourself as member. So when you get registered under Khan Academy, you can join different courses and you can get the courses at your own level.
Now,
so India Education is another a very important platform where students and as well as teacher can see and look for career related information as well as get many online education courses on this platform. As you see, India Education has many colleges who are registered with this platform. They have many courses, they have many online exam, you can say a platform where you can go for different and so on. There are many resources also, textbooks and so on. And there are many links where you can get information about studying in other countries. The Directory of Open Access Books has excellent collection of textbooks or other textbooks which are being followed at many international courses, which you can get the access by searching through this Directory of Open Access Books. Here, thousands of books are available on different subjects. OSIS is another international open education resource platform where you can get open public domain books, textbooks, audio books. You can get course modules under this platform. And there are basically more than 3 lakh records which you can search through this platform and get information on any subject under this platform. Smart Search is a other platform which is available under Manlet database, where you have learning resources, more than 1 lakh learning resources are there. Now this slide is 3 months back. Now they have more than 1 lakh learning resources under this platform. There are presently 17 lakh registered members are from different part of the world who are making use of learning resources under this platform. There are many educational institutions, more than 4,000 educational institutions, many international universities are registered member of this platform. And we have more than 2,000 contributors who are regularly contributing many learning resources on different subject matter here. It is free of cost and you just have to get yourself registered under this platform. And it is very useful for teacher as well as students on getting online education resources on different subjects. Open Geography Education is another platform where you can get many open education resources on the subject of geography. You can get e-textbooks, you can get photographs, you can get maps and many other resources which you can use for your assignments or you can use for your teaching as well. There are many geographical maps which you can use for different subject matter, like you can use population maps or you can use economic maps for making assignments on different subjects. So all the resources are available free of cost and you can make use in your assignment as well as in your designing teaching courses. OpenStack is another initiative by Rice University UK, where they have now put lot of textbooks under different subjects. So many books are available on the subject of math, science, social science, humanities, business essential, business, and there are many essentials books which you can use. And basically all the books are for college level. So the most of the books basically cover the courses which are being run in different colleges. E-Gyankosh is another government initiative where you can get different courses, and it is being developed by the Indira Gandhi Open National University, and they have a full-fledged e-Gyankosh platform where you can get information of all the government initiatives as well as Indira Gandhi National Open University resources, where you can get the courses and where you can get enrolled yourself and get the graduation and post-graduation degrees. And there is another open course library where you can get open educational resources which are being used by different international universities who are imparting education at post-graduation level. So all these universities, they have hosted their open educational resources in open course library. And you, by registering yourself, you can getting access of most of the education resources being developed by many, you can say, world-renowned universities, and you can make use for any course in your institution. Open Professional Education Network is another platform which you can go through and get the open education resources. It is under Creative Commons license, and you can get resources like textbooks, audiovisual material, movies, and so on. So it covers mostly all the subjects which are being instructed in many universities. EDX is a courseware platform where you can get yourself registered for pursuing different education degrees or courses in an open access format. So there are basically more than 2,800 courses, and till date, more than 2,500 million learners have learned different subjects through this EDX courses. And now, till date, presently, they have more than 87 million enrollments all across different part of the world for different courses under this EDX courses. So many international universities host their courses under this platform and run their courses for different level. Even your college can host the different education resources in EDX, like you can run your PGDCA or a MBA program, part of that program like accounting or financial management under EDX platform. You need to get your institution registered under this platform, and you can host your course here, which you require one license agreement you require, and you can charge certain fee also to run your program, where you have to give the certificate to the person who pays the fee. Otherwise, who don't need a certificate, he can learn openly without any cost. W3school.com is another open education resources where you can learn the newer techniques of information technology, like the machine learning, visualization, or so on, or any particular information technology related course you can learn, and you can get the open education resources in w3school.com. This website has a you can say very versatile communication method where you can learn different language, different courses, different programming in a very systematic manner. So if you see, it has courses on HTML, CSS, JavaScript, SQL, PHP, Python, machine learning, and so on. You need to register to get yourself learned under this platform. Online college courses is another platform where many online, many colleges of different countries are hosting their program, and the students can learn online in a virtual online environment. So you, under this platform, students can get the degree, whether they want a graduate, postgraduate, or diploma, or so on. They have to select, and different colleges can get registered themselves and host their program in this platform. So apart from this, there are many other websites where you can learn at your own life. Air Story is a very versatile language website, web platform, where you can learn the language, English language, or any other language at your own level. And it helps you in a very systematic manner, how you can get the pronunciation, how you can see the language, the different pattern of language. This Air Story website has a very, you can say, a very interactive platform where you can learn English or any language freely. 750 Words is another open access website where you can enhance the language of your choice by learning different words in a very convenient manner. So open education Selfie is another international platform. It is being developed by Australian government. It is basically has a content from high school to secondary school level, where you many open education resources are hosted, and students and teacher can impart their learning by making use of this platform. It is an open platform, and even Indian teachers and students can learn different subjects under this platform. EU Science Hub is another international platform where many science open education resources are available. And if you want to have a very reliable and up-to-date information, you can just search for COVID or any science topic to get a very reliable open education resources. So this is all. So when my take is, when you are going for any educational resources, it is very important for you to search for appropriate educational resources. How you can do is, it is very important. So if you are, hello, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello, just hold on.
Yes, sir.
So?
Yes.
So if you are searching for any open education resources, basically if you are going through Google, it is very important if you search through Google Scholar, or you go for a advanced Google search feature which is available in a general search mode, and you always start with the advanced search information feature, okay, where you can just give your query in the query format by entering a subject term. And And if you go through the down, in which language you want, you can select the language. Which country you want, you select the country. You need what date you want, you just select any time, or you can search for open education resources hosted recently, a week ago, a month ago, or a year ago, like that. Site domain, you can select whether you want to search for a open or so, term appearing in any page, any course content or so on, file type, you can simply select if you want a PDF or a audio visual or so on, or a document type format you want. And you have to select for open education resources from user's right. You have to just select free to use, share, or modify. You have to select this option. By selecting this, if you select this and make search, you will get the open education resources which are available freely, and which you can modify at your own, and you can reshare it. You can make use of that resources in your course. So if I have just selected accounting as my search term, I want to search open education search for on the subject of accounting. So I have just selected language, I want English. I want accounting course, accounting open education resources, which are dealing with the accounting of Indian practice. And I have selected from the here, free to use and share mode. If I search, all the resources are now listed, and I can select from any result and go through for educational resources of my choice. So if I tick on any educational resources like accounting, Vidya Mitra, integrated e-content portal, it is under InfoBlend. So these are all the resources which are hosted in an open education resource license and are available freely. So students can use this platform for learning of their course, and teachers can make use of these educational resources while designing their course for imparting different subjects at graduation and post-graduation level. So with this, I think this is all. And when we talk of open education resources, the basic advantage are you can, it has a extending learning feature, means you can learn the things at your own level, at your own time, at your own place, and you need only a device where you can open a educational resources and you can download it. You need a device where you can interact with that open educational resources and you can learn different subject matter. So this is all. If you have any question on how to search on open education resources, or how you can design a open education resource, or you can host a open education resource, you can ask me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your wonderful presentation, explanation, and elaborating OER. Any questions from participants? I think no questions. Any questions from participants? So go ahead.
Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Give me this opportunity to give my presentation on open education.
Okay. Thank you, sir. It's time for feedback now. It is essential for the evaluation. Now I call Uttara Vaidya, final year student of BCCA, Dhanwadi National College, Nagpur. Uttara Vaidya. Please, Uttara. Unmute your mic.
Yes, ma'am. First of all, thanks to DNC College, Honorable Principal Sir, Vaishali Ma'am, Sir, and all the teachers. Because of this, we got a very valuable information about open distance learning at Shala. Special thanks to Pratibha Ma'am. उन्होंने बताया books read करना हमारे लिए कितना important है. एक तरह से सफलता की ओर लेके जाने वाली सीढ़ी के बारे में बताया है. सेशन के बाद से ही मैंने बुक्स पढ़ना स्टार्ट किया है. हार्टफेल्ट थैंक्स फॉर द इंस्पिरेशन मैम. मैं खुद को लकी मानती हूँ कि मुझे यहाँ बोलने का मौका मिला. थैंक यू सो मच टू ऑल. थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू उत्तरा. आई कॉल डॉक्टर पराग जोशी सर.
अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. Rather, it is good afternoon to all of you, good afternoon to all the dignitaries present here. I'm here to present the participants' feedback for this 7 days webinar on access to open educational resources for students, teachers, and researchers. I must appreciate the efforts of the organizers for conducting such informative sessions and inviting excellent resource persons. Dr. Kasturi Pichala, Ma'am Pichala, Dr. Pratibha Daksande, Dr. Kiran Vankhede, Dr. Pooja Dade, Dr. Vaishali Ugle, Dr. Manju Dubey, Dr. Rakesh Mohindra sir was best at their sessions. Actually saying, we have a plenty of educational resources, but maybe due to lack of knowledge and fear, we are not opting it. Many times there is a fear of using that resources sources due to innovativeness, and many times we have a thought like agar maine use kiya galat to nahi hoga ya kuch galti to nahi hogi. So to take over on that fear, hands-on practice is highly required and techniques to implement it that had already delivered by our resource persons, whether it is students, teachers and researchers. So being a participant, I enjoyed this webinar a lot, and I am thankful to Dhanmata National College principal Dr. Surendra Jichkar sir, Dr. Vaishali Malode, librarian and convener of the webinar, Dr. Praveen Gosekar, co-convener, and IQAC coordinator Dr. Belkar sir, Dr. Kulbushan Mege, coordinator of IQAC, for the successful completion of this webinar. We expect many more webinars from Dhanmata National College for better enlightenment on the various issues. Thanks to one and all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Anybody from participants, live participants? कोणाला काही बोलायचं आहे फीडबॅक बद्दल? फीडबॅक द्यायचा
आहे और साइन करके आओ, जाओ.
हॅलो, ओके,
हॅलो
हॅलो
हॅलो.
हा मॅडम, बोला.
थँक्यू मॅम, सच अ नाईस वेबिनार सिरीज. आय हॅव कम टू नो व्हेरी मच रिसोर्सेस फॉर दिस थ्रू दिस वेबिनार. इट वॉज रिमेन अ वंडरफुल वेबिनार, अँड यू हॅव ऑल्सो सेंड द मेसेज ऑफ लेक्चर ऑन द यूट्यूब, दॅट इज मोस्ट यूजफुल फॉर अस अगेन अँड अगेन. थँक्यू सो मच.
थँक्यू मॅम, थँक्यू. So it's a time of vote of thanks. ID
ye vote of thanks boli.
I deem it a great honor to propose the vote of thanks to all who have aided us in making this webinar such a resounding success. First of all, I would like to propose healthy vote of thanks to our chief guest and my guru, Dr. Mohan Kherde sir, director KRC Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University, for gracing today's webinar. Thank you sir for your very interesting and thought providing address. I would like to thank our distinguished speakers, Dr. Rakesh Mohindra sir, for making excellent presentation and making this webinar interesting and meaningful. I would like to express our profound gratitude to our principal Dr. Surendra Jichkar sir for his presence. Thank you sir for your very interesting and for his presence in this webinar and giving me an opportunity to conducting this 7 days program. I would also like to express my thanks to coordinator IQAC for his moral support and guidance. I would like to deep gratitude to co-coordinator of IQAC for his moral support and guidance. I would like to thank all resource persons for our 7 days webinar, Dr. Kasturi Pesala, Dr. Pratibha Taksande, Dr. Kiran Vankade, Dr. Pooja Dade, Dr. Vaishali Ugle, and Dr. Manju Dubey and Rakesh Mohindra for their wonderful lectures. I am happy to express vote of thanks to our staff members who have made this webinar a great success. I am very thankful to our co-convener, Dr. Praveen Gosekar sir, for his technical support throughout this webinar. I am also thankful to Dr. Parag Joshi sir, Dr. Muktai Chavan madam, and Dr. Rajesh Timane sir for their constant support. I am also thankful to my daughter Anushree Malode for her innovative ideas and support. I would like to thank the participants from all over the India. Make these sessions of this webinar a great success. finally, to wonderful students who have turned up in such a great numbers, not only from our colleges, from Dhanwati National College, but also from other colleges in Nagpur, Wardha, and all over India. Thank you so much for your cooperation. Once again, I thank all of you for your cordial cooperation. I hope by now your mirror would have turned into windows. Thank you. Thank you so much. I have announced feedback link would be provided on the Telegram group and WhatsApp group. Thank you. Thank you so much. I have concluded the session.